Welcome to episode 50 of the What Shara Made podcast. Welcome back if you are a returning viewer, and a big hello if this is the first time you're watching me today. I've got lots of whips as usual, but I've got a couple of FOs and I've got a few future projects to show you as well, and a little bit of design work. So I might just get straight into the whips. The first one that I've got is something that my mum has commissioned me to make for one of her dear friends who is turning 50? Maybe she's turning 60, I don't know. She's one of those ageless women. Anyway, she's having a big special birthday and my mum wanted me to make her a shawl. So I showed my mum a few different designs of shawls that I know are really beautiful and everyone likes them, and the one she chose was the Random Acts of Colour, and I can't remember who designed that now, so I'll put it down here. But it's a beautiful shawl, and if you're a regular viewer, you might remember I made one last year for my best friend's birthday, and that was very warmly received. She really liked it, but this time the one I'm making for my mum's friend is a little bit different because the pattern is actually written for fingering weight yarn or 4-ply yarn, sock yarn. But of all the yarns that I showed mum at our local yarn store, she didn't like any of those that were the right weight. And she chose a DK weight yarn that's really beautiful. One of my favourites, the Clayton Superfine Merino, and it's absolutely beautiful. It's a DK weight, so I'm making this fingering weight shawl with DK weight yarn, and it's going through the yarn a lot. I'm probably 4 balls in at present, but it's looking gorgeous. I can't quite show you what it looks like in its entirety because I'm halfway through a row and I've run out of that colour yarn, so I'm waiting to get a new ball of that. So I can keep going, but you get the idea. You can see here, I've got this colour here is called Iceberg, and on the screen it's actually showing as a really pale sort of lilac colour. It isn't actually that colour in real life, it's more of a super pale blue-grey iceberg colour, if you will. And then got this like a medium grey here, warm grey there, and then this colour that is simply called maroon. It is sort of a, if you're familiar with Quince & Co, it's the same colour as the Malbec. It's a really beautiful wine kind of colour, and they look gorgeous together, and you can get a bit of an idea of what it's going to look like. But I think I might need to cut it short because I've still got quite a bit to go if I follow the pattern word for word. But it's already 170 centimetres long, and the person that she's giving it to is around about my height, and that will mean this shawl will be a bit too long if I keep making it longer. So as long as it's deep enough, I might sort of alter the pattern a little bit so that I don't have to keep buying more balls of yarn, but also so it's not too gigantic. You want it to still be practical. So that is Random Acts of Colour. It's a real pleasure to knit, actually. It's super easy, really intuitive. You can count what's happening without having to tick rows off, and that's one of my favourite sorts of patterns, when you can read the work instead of having to constantly refer to the pattern. So that is that whip. I've got to have it done by the end of May. So I've still got plenty of time, and it is working out very quickly, but I'd love to get it done. so I can have it blocked and ready for Mum to give to her friend. And my next whip that I will show you, just trying to decide which one to show you. I might show you this one. You might remember in the last episode, I was talking about my Issy socks. They now have a name. I don't know if they had a name in the last episode, but they're my brioche socks. You can see, with a bit of grass on them. So they're my brioche socks, and oh my god, they're so squishy and lovely. They're a little bit too big for my blockers, so they are looking a little bit floppy. And I finished the pair and I've written the pattern up, and the pattern is now with the testers. I've got a beautiful group of testers that are helping with this, and I've been looking at their progress pictures, and they are just, oh gosh, they've chosen the best colours. So you can see there what's going on with those. I don't know if I had one finished in the last episode or not, but you can see there what's happening with them. So that isn't a whip because it's an FO, but I've started another pair in some other yarn that I had in my stash. And I don't know if you can see there, it's not showing up quite as magnificent on the screen as it is in real life. This yarn here is, I'm trying to get, no, it's much more mustardy or honey. It's coming out quite pale on the screen, but it's much more vibrant in real life. And this is the other yarn, and you might remember I knit my sister a pair of socks from this yarn for her birthday earlier in the year. I showed them on the podcast, or did I? Maybe I didn't. I might have shown a picture. But you get the idea of what's happening. So this has got a little bit of a tweed look to it, and this is the yarn that I've dyed myself. And I'm really enjoying these. I think I like this colour combo better than this colour combo, but they're both cool. So I'm really enjoying those. So the Issy sock pattern will actually be out very, very soon. So if you've had your eye on that, or if you feel like knitting yourself some squishy, delicious, cozy brioche socks, keep your eye out. You'll definitely see it on Instagram. It'll probably be in the next 2 weeks or so from the date of this filming, and it's the 13th of April today, right now, while I'm filming. And I plan on finalising that pattern next week, fingers crossed. But I want to be able to have these finished and photographed to show in the pattern as well. So once you see these pop up as an FO on Instagram, the pattern will not be too far behind. So that's that whip. My next whip is also a design whip, but it's not gotten very far, but I guess you can still see some of it. I'm working on another brioche shawl design, and I'm just sort of playing around with patterns and experimenting with different shapes and things like that, but you get the idea of what's going on. So you can see there that leaf design in the middle there, and I plan to have that continuing on down the pattern and through the sides of the shawl. And there's these little blips along the top as well, little buds up there. I don't know exactly how this pattern's going to go. It's just still a work in progress. I'm still playing around, experimenting with things, but you get some idea of the pattern from the back as well. It looks pretty interesting. Sometimes brioche patterns look really similar from the back of the front, and other times they take on a really different personality on the other side. And that's one of the things I love about brioche knitting, is that you can get something so different on either side, and so vibrant. And the colours you choose as well really, really make a difference, just like anything really. But yeah, I'm very happy with that. And I also hope to make this design, use these features, to make a brioche poncho. I've got this idea that's been in my head for about 2 years now for a brioche poncho, and I really need to get cracking and just get it out of my brain and into real life, because I want to wear it. Finally, the weather is turning much cooler, and it means I finally started being able to wear knitwear again. It didn't feel like it was ever going to get cool again, but now it's quite beautiful. Oh, there's a tiny little wren just outside my window. I wish you could see. It's gone now. But it's a beautiful sunny day today, actually. The weather is finally true Melbourne autumn weather, where it's freezing in the morning, beautiful during the day, low 20s, just gorgeous, and then it's freezing at night. So that's my favourite kind of weather. But this, hopefully, will turn into a pattern. You'll see it coming along in the podcasts and on Instagram. And of course, when it's ready for testing, I'll put a call out. So if that's something that interests you, keep an eye out for that. My next whip is also another design whip, and it doesn't look like much at this stage, and you'll just have to trust me when I describe to you what it's going to look like. So far, I've got this. What is it, you ask? Well, you can sort of tell there. This is the back of what is going to become a waistcoat. You can't really tell there because it's all curly and there's bits hanging off, but I'm sure you get the idea. Here's the back, these are the fronts, and I've just cast on for the underarms. And despite the size of it, or what it looks like now, it is indeed going to be for me. I've done a lot of measurements and it should fit without looking ridiculous. There's obviously a fair bit to go. But it's going to have a little interesting shaping detail on the back here, just in the small of the back. And it's going to have, surprise of all surprises, some brioche in it. I'm still on my brioche bender, and it's going to have a brioche border, and I think it's gonna look pretty cool, but we'll have to wait and see when it's done if it's as cool as I'm imagining it or if it just looks ridiculous. I won't know until I've done it. But the brioche border is going to be this colour as the main colour, and this is from Oyster Yarns, and it's called Twizzler or Twizzle Stick, but anyway, it's a discontinued line, so don't get too excited about it. I am loving working with it. It is beautiful, and I don't know if you can see. Oh yeah, you can see there. It's sort of got a mild effect because it's the construction is 3 plies. It's a DK weight yarn. 2 of the plies are superwash merino, and 1 of the plies is non-superwash merino. And when you dye those, so they're plied and made into a undyed yarn together, and then when they dyed, the superwash yarn and the non-superwash yarn take up dye differently. So they're all the same colour before they dyed, but when you dye them, you get two of the plies taking up the colour one way, and one of the plies taking up the colour a different way. So that's how you get this mild effect. And when it's knit into a fabric, it just looks beautiful. Try not to drag the needles on the table because I know it makes a horrible sound. So you get the idea of the fabric here. It's beautiful, and the yarn is just, oh, it feels so gorgeous and sturdy and rustic but soft. I don't know how to describe it. I'm absolutely loving it. They've still got some left in their shop, but not in this colour, so fingers crossed I have enough to finish this because I can't get it again. I have got a backup yarn that's somewhat similar to this that I could add in, but I've got another 100 grams of this, and I haven't used 50 grams yet, so I should actually get the body of this done with less than 100 grams, so the border will, I'll still have more than 100 grams to do the border, and that should be plenty. So I'm feeling a bit more confident about my yarn quantities now that I'm at this point. When I first started it, I was freaking out that I wasn't going to have enough yarn and then I will have wasted the knitting, and you know what I mean. Anyway, that's coming along. Hopefully I will have a bit more of this to show you next time, because it's knitting up really quickly. I started it last night, and of course when you're designing something at the same time as you're knitting it, it takes two times, three times as long. But if you were just knitting this straight from the pattern, you would have been able to have this done in a couple of hours. So I'm excited to keep working on that this afternoon. And that is all for my whips. All for my knitting whips, anyway. But I have left one somewhere else, so hold on one moment and I'm going to get it. So, it's not a whip at all, it's an FO. It has been blocked, it hasn't had the ends woven in, I literally just cast it off. But it is another piece, another sample of my Fernshawe shawl. So, it's pretty big, it's not going to fit in the screen. Here's the other side, you get a bit more of an idea of the really subtle little pattern that runs down the middle of the shawl there. It's not very good contrast on the screen between these two yarns, but this beautiful yarn was donated to me by the lovely Nicole from the Yarn Adelaide podcast, who has the Collar Girl Collective Yarns on Etsy. And this gorgeous red colour is Rhubarb Crumble. And this colour is Spiced Chai. Oh god, that Spiced Chai, it is gorgeous. So I can't wait to block this and have it all ready and beautiful and finished. It already feels gorgeous, so it's only going to get more beautiful after blocking, and feel more beautiful after blocking. So I'm really excited about this. I'm hoping that my brother, who is a photographer, will help me photograph the shawls over the Easter weekend, and then they'll be ready to put in the pattern, because the pattern is presently being tested by another group of amazing testers that have been helping me out, and the test period is just about over and they're all doing beautifully. So that's been fantastic, and these testers have really been invaluable. It's been amazing. So that is the Fernshawe shawl. Now, it's a very, very easy brioche pattern. If you have wanted to do some brioche, make a brioche shawl, and you've ever wondered about shaping and how that works, and anything like that, and you've got two spare skeins of sock yarn, this is the pattern for you. Even if you've never done brioche before, you'll be able to do this. If you can knit and purl, you can do this. So that is the Fernshawe shawl. I'm so excited about it, and I can't wait to block this so I can wear it around. I'm loving it. So that is that FO, and keep your eye out on Instagram, because that pattern's going to be out really, really soon. And as part of this pattern, lovely Nicole, who donated this yarn to me for this sample, has actually got some kits organised for it. So she's going to have either two skeins of her drover yarn or two skeins of her, let me check, I've got the information here and I've forgotten it. Excuse me while I just look it up. She did just text me. So, Facebook's changed on my phone recently. Bear with me while I just look at this. Oh good, it's taking forever. So, she will have the kits of variegated, speckled and tonal dyed colourways in her drover with sock base, which is this one, beautiful. And they will be $40 for the kit, and normally that would be $48, but she's doing a special deal for the furniture shawl, which is awesome. And I will put links to Nicole's shop in my Ravelry group so that you can find it easily and go straight there. And she's also got kits of her beautiful little Outback yarn, which is really gorgeous, really beautiful. And those kits will be $45, and they're normally $52, so that's a great discount if you want to get the kit in the same yarns that I've used here. I don't know if she's going to have these two colours, but she'll have some other beautiful colours. She's really clever with her colours, so I'm looking forward to seeing those kits come up. And that will give you enough yarn to make your own furniture shawl, and that's great value. So head on over to that link in the Ravelry group, which you will be able to find easily once the pattern's released. So that is really exciting. I'm so excited about being able to release this pattern. It's been such a pleasure working with the testers and developing this pattern. Just beautiful. Love it. Now, my next FO was sort of a collaboration. I was doing a sample for my local yarn store, and I started it, and then I didn't have time to finish it in time for when they wanted it. So another lovely knitter who does sample knitting for the shop as well took it over, and she finished it. She's done a beautiful job, and then I got it back to do the blocking. And I'm hoping that somehow I'm adding a picture of the pre-blocked shawl here. And then, and she was really worried that she'd done something wrong. I'm like, no, it's totally exactly how it's meant to look. It just urgently needs to be blocked. And then I blocked it and got this beautiful result. So, it made a huge difference. It's still a little bit pouchy there because you've got squishy garter stitch and then this slip stitch, and this stitch, just by its very nature, is much, much tighter than squishy old garter stitch. So it was actually, I don't know, it's an unusual choice to put garter stitch next to this really tight stitch, particularly in a crescent shape shawl that already has this pouch tendency at the beginning, and then followed on with a really tight stitch. That was an unusual choice, but I guess they probably had a reason for doing it. But when it's being worn, that pouch isn't so obvious, and it's definitely better than pre-blocking. So got it there, and the yarn that's being used for this is called California, and it's another Claqueton yarn. And this is one of their recent patterns, so the local yarn store wanted a sample of it, and it's come up beautifully. So that was a little bit of a collaboration FO. It's come along there. Now I've got another FO. If you are doing, you may have seen this last episode, if you are taking part in the Adiday Designs Three Springs mystery crochet along, and you haven't finished yours yet and you don't want to see what the finished product looks like, look away now. Are you looking away? Okay, because I'm going to show mine now. This is the Three Springs mystery crochet along. The pattern is by the beautiful Deanne of Adiday Designs. How cool is this? How beautiful is it? Oh, it was such a pleasure to make. I just loved it, and I was hanging out for every clue to come out. It's very, very long, way longer than my wingspan. And it's just beautiful. I absolutely love it. And it hasn't been blocked yet, but it's not that... you could probably get away with not blocking it. It's not desperate for a block. There's no tight weirdness across the top or anything. It's beautiful. And I've already been wearing it around. I wore it around yesterday and I loved it. I sort of had it this way, but I had it wrapped around multiple times, and so that I had it all kind of, I don't know if I'm going to be able to do it. I can see myself on the screen here, but I did need a mirror to sort of get myself sorted yesterday. But I headed out really early in the morning yesterday, and it was quite foggy, and having this all, I don't know how to do it, having this all wrapped around me while I was out and about early in the morning was a beautiful, and I got lots of compliments from other early morning walkers, and the yarn, my god, it's so soft, it's such a pleasure to wear. The yarn is, let me tell you, this beautiful colour here, and see, it's got the sandy colours, but it's also got these little blips of red, and there's even some teeny tiny little blips of green as well. And it is called East Beach, and it's from the lovely Hannah of the Rosehip Island Etsy shop, and she is one of my favourite hand dyers. I'm constantly perusing her shop, waiting for new colours to come out and trying to think of ways to use them, so I've got an excuse to buy more. And I just love it, it's so soft. This is on her Oz sock base, maybe it's on the NZ sock base, I can't remember, whichever one it is delicious. It's so soft and squishy. I've really been enjoying wearing this. The dark line here is sort of a tonal, very dark charcoal, and that is from Dingo Dyeworks. It's the Wallaroo colourway, and this peachy colour down here is a mystery sock yarn from maybe 7 or 8 years ago. It was deep stash, didn't have a label anymore. I don't know what it is, I just know it's sock yarn. And it's a 75/25, and it's lovely, and I felt like it just was the right color to go with the other two. But I can see great potential with this shawl, where you don't have to just stick to three colours. You could just go with two colours if that's what you had, but you could go crazy. Like, you could do this section in one colour, then that stripe in another, that stripe in another, that stripe in another. You could go really wild with this. You could have loads of colours if you wanted to. And to be honest, I actually think it would look quite magnificent in one solid colour. It would still be beautiful in a solid colour, so that's a testament to a great design when it can look beautiful in so many different variations of yarn. But I'm really going to enjoy wearing this around. It's so nice. So that is the finished Three Springs shawl by Addie Day Designs. I urge you to go and check out Deanne's designs if you are a crocheter, because they are just beautiful, really gorgeous. She does a gorgeous job. She writes her patterns really well. They're easy to understand, and she's really friendly and lovely. So if you had any questions, she would be more than happy to help you out. So that is the Three Springs shawl. Now, if you were looking away because you didn't want the mystery spoiled, you can look back now. Now, I've got one more whip to show you, but it's not a knitting whip. It's not even a yarny whip. It's a quilting whip. Did I mention that last time that I had been doing a quilting course? I have been doing a quilting course, and in our course we made a teeny tiny, excuse me, teeny tiny little mini quilt to teach us all the skills so that we could go on and make a giant quilt if we felt like it. So excuse me, I haven't quite finished this, so there's still a needle and thread in it. And it has been folded up in a bag, so it's a little bit wrinkly, but anyway, I'm sure you'll forgive me for that. So this is my little quilt. I'm pretty excited about it. I know it's very plain and ordinary and not a lot of, you know, magnificent skills went into it, but it's the first thing I've ever done of this nature, and I'm in love with it. I am addicted. Of course, it helps that my quilting teacher is an absolute delight, but she's also extremely skilled and just out of this world clever with her quilting. So that really made it a pleasure. And I was so excited about this. You can see I haven't quite finished sewing the binding on. It's all still flapping around. Hopefully I can finish that in the next few days. But what has happened since doing this is that I could not stop thinking about quilting and all the different amazing things you can do with quilting. And I actually bought one of my teacher's patterns. She's got some pretty magnificent quilting patterns, and I got her pattern called Blush. And I'm going to make my delightful friends a quilt for their baby that is due in a few months. And I got some fabric from my local yarn store. They sell fabric as well, Crumbs Craft in Hillsville. They're so beautiful. And the fabric that I've got to make this Blush quilt is, let me see if it says it on the salvage, because I think it does. I did see it somewhere. Maybe I am imagining that. It's Robert Kaufman, I believe, and it's got a name, has a name, because I saw it somewhere on here. Here we go. It is Robert Kaufman, and it's for Robert Kaufman. It's by Carolyn Friedlander, and it is the Euclid design. I don't know how. Oh yeah, you can see it on there. So this is an undyed linen with the white Euclid print on it, and this is sort of a chambray coloured linen with like a, it actually looks brown on screen, but it's like a mustard Euclid print on it. And then I got this linen cotton chambray to go with it, and that is going to turn into a baby-sized Blush quilt, and I'm so excited to start it. And I was hoping to do it over the Easter long weekend, but I think I'm going to have a house full of people instead, and it might be a bit weird if I just go off and start quilting. I am going to the Australian Quilt Convention. I don't know what it's actually called. AQC is the initials about the show. And that is on next week, and I am so excited. It's on in the city, and I am going in next week, and I've got a little shopping list written for myself, and I have a feeling I'm going to be a bit overwhelmed. I've been to the show before, but I didn't really have an interest in quilting. I was just sort of going for other sewing things and crafty things. But now that I'm obsessed with quilting, it's going to be a whole different story. I am hoping that I only get the things on my shopping list, but you know I'm going to see pretty things that I won't be able to leave behind. But I'm really excited for that next week. So possibly in the next episode that you see from me, I will have a few more quilting things to show you. And I might even have the beginnings of that Blush quilt to show you as well. Hopefully I do, because I'm so excited to start it. So that is all of my crafty adventures since the last time we spoke, which was a little while ago. I have been pretty busy with all sorts of different crafty things. It's the Easter long weekend coming out. It's Good Friday tomorrow. I have got my sister's dog with me, one of her dogs, staying with me, and she is my dog Rosie's best friend. They are obsessed with each other. They've been playing like absolute maniacs all morning, and now they've slinked off to separate areas to have a little nap, which is interesting because they did not sleep much last night, and as a result, neither did we. But that's okay. She's still getting used to staying at her Auntie Rara's house. So I'm looking at her. She's such a gorgeous little fluff ball over there on the couch. I wonder if I can show you her because she's so cute. Hang on. So this is Bella. Very sleepy. Just got woken up from the couch. What a gorgeous little sleepy papa. So this is my sister's dog Bella. She likes to give kisses. We don't know what she is. She's just a little fluff ball that my sister rescued. I love you too, darling. You want to smile for the camera? See? It's you on there. Hi. Aww. You're a very sleepy girl. Oh, little Bell Bells. You're a gorgeous girl. Aww. You're too sleepy to be a podcaster. So this is Bella, and she's staying with me for the long weekend. And little gorgeous fluffy face. Oh, sleepy head. You gonna be a good girl tonight? Yeah? Yeah, of course, Bella. She's so adorable. Yeah, gorgeous girl. Yeah. Oh. But I think that's all from me now. You'll see any updates on patterns and releases of patterns. Oh, you're going to wiggle off now. Oh, don't sit that way. You're going to slide off, little pup. Any updates on that will be on Ravelry and Instagram. So keep a track there, and I'll see you all again soon. I think Bella wants to get down. See you later. Bye.